Hello, good morning. I am Vishali. Today I am going to explain you about replacement problem, third example. So this third example will be under the category of replacement of items that deteriorates. Under this replacement of item that deteriorates, I have explained you when money value is constant. We have done two examples related to it. Okay, now today I'll be discussing about this type, that when money value changes with the, in 2019, if the value of 100 rupees is 100 rupees and in 2020 it will be 110 or 111, it is like this. So every year there is an increment of the value of the money. Okay, so in this chapter, which factors we'll be keeping in the mind is: present value of 1 rupee money spent n years from now is called as present worth factor. So this term you will be reading in this part, that present worth factor. What is present worth factor? The value of 1 rupee spent n years from now is called as present worth factor. The rate of interest R. If R is the rate of interest, then you can say 1 plus R to the power minus n is called as present worth factor. So, present worth factor is the rate of interest that we have to keep in the mind while solving such type of questions. So, PWF can also be written as 1 upon 1 plus R to the power N, where R represent the rate of interest. How much value of the money is increased in number of the years, that we will study in the present worth factor. Okay, and that the number of the value of the money increases in n years, and the rate of interest, how much it is increased with respect to rate of interest, we have to calculate the present worth factor. For this we will be using this formula. As of now, this is sufficient for you to understand. Now moving directly to the question, and then I'll make you understand how we can use it. Okay, now this is the question. Let the value of money be assumed to be 10% per year. See, in I'll be giving the link in the description box below for my two previous videos. When money value is constant, in that question, if you have done those questions, you know that we does not have such type of, no rate of interest kind of a thing is given. Directly the maintenance value, scrap value is given, and then you can calculate and the purchase price of that machine. But in this question, when money value changes with the time, in such type of questions you will be having a rate of interest. Okay. Let the value of the money be assumed to be 10% per year, and suppose that machine A is replaced after every 3 years. So we have two machines, machines A and machines B in this question. Machine A is replaced after every 3 years. So we have machine of two types, machine A and machine B. We have two types of machine, machine A and machine B. This machine A is replaced after every 3 years. So it is replaced after every 3 years. Then machine B is replaced after every 6 years. They are kind of machine. So these type of machines are replaced by every 3 years, and these kind of machine is replaced by every 6 years. Okay. Yearly cost of both the machines are given. So in every year, the cost of machine A is this, means the machine cost, it decreases then increases. It's like this. These are the cost of machines are given. Now determine which machine should be purchased. So which machine we have to purchase so that we'll be get profit. So that we have to calculate. Now I'll tell you how to do such type of questions. Present worth factor. What is the formula for present worth factor? PWF you can write. What is the formula for it? 1 upon 1 plus R to the power N. Okay. Now N, let N for 1 year, if we'll take, taking N equal to 1 year, the rate of interest. The rate of interest I just told you is 10% per year. Okay. So it will become 10%. Rate of interest is 10%. Now we just calculate the value. It will become PWF will become 1 upon 1 plus R upon 100. Okay. And time is 1. So this will become 100 upon 100 plus 10. So this will become 100 upon 110. So 10 by 11. Okay, so this is the present worth factor. So PWF is for your question is 10 upon 11. Now we have to calculate that determine which machine should be purchased, machine A and machine B. A is replaced after every 3 years. So, we have to calculate the A. So, for A, for machine A, okay, for machine A, what we are calculating? We will be calculating total present value factor, present worth factor. For machine A, the total present worth factor for 3 years. Okay, that means how much total money is required for machine A in 3 years. So, for that, the cost of machine in 1 year is 1000 rupees. So, if we'll take the cost of machine for first year, it is 1000 rupees plus. Okay, for first year it is 1000 rupees. Now, for second year, it is 200 rupees, but 200 rupees is for second year, but the value is increased by 10 upon 11 because this is the present worth factor. Every year, the some percentage of money will increase, that will be added to the previous year money. So, same we have done it here. Okay, so third year value is 400, then 400 will be multiplied by 10 upon 11 ka square. Why? It is 400 into 10 upon 11, 2. Why? Because n value becomes 2 for third year, n value becomes 1 for first year, n value second year, n value becomes 0 for first year. N value 0, n is 0 because this is the starting of the first year. So, no present worth factor will be applied. Here, 1 year is gone, this is the second year. So, n value will become 1 for here. And this is n value become 2 for here. Okay, this is for third year n value become 2. So, this you have to keep in your mind while solving the questions. So, when we do the total of this, this will become 1000 plus 1512. Okay, so this is the present worth factor, total present worth factor for the machine A. Now we will be calculating the total present factor for machine. So total present worth factor for, this is we are doing for machine B, so total present worth factor for 6 years. Because for machine B, we will be considering this for 6 years. Okay, you can write it like this, the total discount cost of B for 6 years, this way also you can write. Okay, for machine B, for 6 years, you have to see the cost. The cost is 1700 and like this, that we have to see. Either you can write this line or you can write the total discount. The total discount cost of B, that is for, of machine B for 6 years. Anything you can write, either you can go for this statement or you can go for that statement. Now let us start. 1700 is the cost of first year. 1700 is the cost of first year. Second year cost is 100 rupees. So 100 into factor PWF is 10 upon 11. So this is N will become 1 for second year. Okay, then plus 200 for third year into 10 upon 11, n will become 2. I just explain you. Now, for fourth year, it is 300 into 10 upon 11 will become, n will become 3 here, plus 400, 10 upon 11 will become to the power 4 here, plus, this is for fifth year, for sixth year it is 500 into 10 upon 11 to the power 4 is here, so we will be right 5 here. Okay, because for this is 6th year, so n will be 1 less, so it will become 5. Okay. Now, when you will solve this value, you will get rupees 2765. Okay. Now, after calculating the total value, we have to calculate the average yearly cost for A and average yearly cost for B. Okay, then we can compare the values and we can calculate which machine should we buy. So, then second thing is we have to calculate the average yearly cost average yearly cost of machine A. Okay, see, we have calculated the total cost for 6 years, total cost for 3 years. Now we are calculating the average yearly cost. Okay, for comparison, for average yearly cost for machine A, we have considered 3 years. So the total cost was 1512. So 1512 divided by 3 will give you 504 rupees. Okay, now average yearly cost of machine B is this much, 2765 divided by 6, because for B we have considered 6 years, it is replaced after every 6 years, so this will become rupees 461. Now we can compare the values. Okay, now but you have to keep in your mind one thing, that machine A we are replacing after every 3 years and machine B we are replacing after every 6 years. So comparison is not proper. We have to compare the machine when we are replacing at the same year. Okay, it means in the same duration of the time. So first thing what I want to tell you, that it shows there is an advantage with B, because comparison, what we say is comparison is not unfair because the periods of consideration is different. So that I want to write it here. Yes. Okay, so comparison of years are different for both the machines. So what we can do, we just calculate the total total discount cost for machine A for 6 years and then we can compare it. Okay, if we consider period of 6 years for machine A, discount cost of A in 6 years is 1,000. So as I told you, the comparison for both is not correct, because one, machine A we are considering for 3 years, machine B we are considering, for machine A we are considering 3 years, for machine B we are considering 6 years. So what we can say, we can say the comparison is not correct, comparison is not equal. So comparison between the two is not correct. So it's better we can go for machine A for 6 years and then we can compare both. So this we are doing here. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. Now just calculating the value for machine A. For machine A, the cost is like this. So you know how I have already told you this, 1000, okay, plus 200 into 10 upon 11 to the power 1, plus 400 into 10 upon 11 to the power 2, plus 1000 rupees into 10 upon 11 to the power 3, plus 200 into 10 upon 11 to the power 4, plus 400 into 10 upon 11 to the power 5. So when you calculate this, you will get the value of the money is rupees 2647. Now after that, what we have done for A and B, we have calculated the average yearly cost. So same we will do for A with respect to 6 years. So average yearly cost, average yearly cost of A will become 2647 divided by 6 will give you rupees 442. So now we can compare this price. Okay, A is rupees 442, for machine B is rupees 461. Okay, so now you can compare. The average cost for machine B is 461 and for machine A is 442. So they have asked you to determine which machine should be purchased. So we have to purchase the machine in which we are getting profit. So machine A, we should purchase machine A. Okay, so this should be the answer. Should be purchased. Thanks. I hope this question is clear to you. Please like, subscribe and share my channel, and please post the comment if you have any query in any topic in operation research, and please subscribe.